being an epidemiologist and somebody who has a career in prevention, I want people to prevent their atrial fibrillation from occurring in the first place. Most of what we know about the prevention of atrial fibrillation is what we call inferential, meaning we don't have large randomized controlled trials that say, yep, you know, if you do X, Y, or Z, then you will prevent yourself going into atrial fibrillation. But we do have a lot of insights from the observational or epidemiological studies. So for instance, very consistently, obesity has been associated with an increased risk of atrial fibrillation. High blood pressure, not only the having high blood pressure, but how high the blood pressure is associated with atrial fibrillation. And there's an emerging story that sleep apnea predisposes, or at least is associated with atrial fibrillation. They not uncommonly happen together. And if people don't get their sleep apnea treated, the atrial fibrillation is more likely to run on for a long time. Having poorly controlled or having heart failure is associated with atrial fibrillation. So there are a lot of lifestyle and treatment things that a patient can do to prevent themselves going on to atrial fibrillation. One of my colleagues just did a study in a biracial population. It turns out something like half of atrial fibrillation is of unknown cause, but at least half of atrial fibrillation is because people do not have optimal or good risk factors. And so people can do a lot to prevent atrial fibrillation. It turns out that if you adjust for all the other risk factors that are in and of themselves inherited, like blood pressure, that atrial fibrillation is also inherited. So I think that patients around the country really need to ask when a family member, a first degree family member, a parent, a sibling, a child, has some kind of health condition, they should ask, what is it? So there is an increased risk on the order of, depending upon all sorts of things like how young your parent was or how young your sibling was and how many of your siblings, probably on the order of a doubling in the risk. So it's important to know if you have a family history, just the way it's important to know if you have a family history of heart disease, you know, you better, you know, if you have a family history of heart attack, you need to get your cholesterol screened, you need to get your blood pressure screened, you need to have good, get regular exercise. There are all sorts of things you can do to prevent yourself from either having a heart attack or postponing it. And I think in the next 10 to 15 years, hopefully we will have better understanding of how to prevent atrial fibrillation's onset. For the time being, it's very clear. You need to have your blood pressure treated and you need not to be obese.